focus is on cutting edge domain knowledge and benchmarking with world class businesses.
Big Tech.
That's when you
quit
Amazon to start Flipkart. And he had this status message that said Flipkart.com. What is this company? I didn't even pronounce it properly. And he said, oh, we started this e-commerce company and it would be great if you put a link on your academic website to Flipkart.com. So I did that and it was interesting. Like, he never imagined this company would be, of course, I never imagined, I didn't give him enough credit back then, but he himself did not imagine that the company would be $1 billion company. I think current valuation is $11 billion, right?
Yeah.
Their expectation was they'd grow it up to $100 million and sell it to Amazon or whoever, and I think that vision changed. But yeah, it's important to see how you don't have to think about starting a $1 billion company. You can start from something small, start off making a change. And this is for all the would-be entrepreneurs in the room. Start getting, I think action is very important, right? When you think about starting up something. This, you'll figure out the strategy, you'll figure out who to hire, but start. I think that's the first thing. But I'll sort of try to take over from here and talk about what is his experience. Again, he started the world between
US. I think, as Hari said, it's definitely become. I mean, it is hard to for folks who haven't, who don't know what India was like 20 years ago. It's like describing a different world, right? It's a different country. So it's hard to put in words exactly how much the opportunity has exploded. I won't repeat what Hari said because I agree with all of that, but I do think that there aren't enough companies in India being started by young people today who have a genuine sense of how they're going to make a very concrete sort of dent on the universe, as they phrase it, over the next 20 years, right? So I think while, yes, a lot of folks have picked up on the let's start a company, let's go try to raise some money. But really, that isn't. It doesn't matter. The money doesn't matter. The valuations are immaterial. You will remember the journey if you build something that you feel like really sort of mattered, right? So, India's had a long history of very powerful entrepreneurs who started businesses in the most hostile environment that ever existed, I think, for businesses. So we've always had that history, and now that the environment has actually gotten better. And both on the government and on the policy side, there's a lot more focus on sort of making it possible for you to start companies. This is probably perhaps the best time there's been since forever to start something. So, and start something big, and to think big about sort of what's possible. I know the Economic Times and other folks like to report valuation numbers because it's easy to quantify, but that's not the game. It is not. The game is about sort of doing something that's A, durable, and B, sort of, will make a sort of a huge difference, going forward. And there's some more stories about that I'll talk about as the panel progresses. Yeah. But yeah.
Perspective on what has changed in the country. So I started my first job, almost now 16 years back, and I used to work with Microsoft in the US, and that was pretty much, people were said, hey, dude, you looks like you made it, right? That is it. And 3 years later, my parents were still packing their bags because they wanted to come to the US to say that, hey, my son actually lives in the US, I want to do a tour of the US. And before they could complete packing their bag, I was actually back in India, primarily because they wanted to start something. And people asked me, what do you want to start? And I am a technologist, my dad is a doctor, so maybe I'll do something in the healthcare space. That is all that I knew, right? So I was. And so I kind of came back, right? And I think I'm a big fan of the fact that when you really want to do something very badly, the entire universe conspires you to give it to you. And so one thing led to another, and in first 4 months, 5 months of me coming back to India, multiple things happened. I had a near fatal accident that happened, and then I ended up starting a company as well, and little did I realize that those are very similar in nature, in reality. So I started that, and honestly, I did not know, that I wanted to create a large company, small company. I just wanted to know that I wanted to do something which I liked. right? And fortunately, it worked out beautifully for me. You know, the first year, and coming from a middle class family, I didn't know about any investor, I didn't know about any entrepreneur, neither did I care about anyone, honestly, right? All that I basically knew that, hey, this is me and I am good. That is all that, whether it was right or the wrong notion in my head. So that is the confidence that I had. And then I ended up starting that company, and then of course things worked out for me. Now I'm on the other side of the table, and I'm a VC investor. There are people who come to me, and they're almost like with authority asking that, hey, I've started this great company. Why will you not put money in my company, right? So that is the conversation that has started to happen, and I like that cockiness as well, right? So the point I'm trying to make is that the India has completely moved from a particular perspective to a different perspective. So there probably I echo what Roy has been saying, right? You know that there probably has never been a better time to start a company right now, and do it for the reasons, not necessarily what Economic Times reports about, but because you like it and because you want to actually make a difference out of it. You know, any company, in India is a very long term game. You'll probably spend next 10-12 years of your life building that. You'll probably have two, three near death events happening for your company. So until you like it, you will not be able to.